In his book, The Power of Broke, Damon John, an entrepreneur and a Shark Tank star, shows us how empty pockets, a tight budget, and a certain mindset can become our greatest competitive advantage. The big idea at the heart of the book is when you start from a place of nothing, when you are hungry and focused on succeeding, then you've got a running start. The book is for people of all ages, at all stages of life. You will find stories to inspire you to follow your own path. The stories show that you don't need a lot of resources to change your life. Sometimes, everything you need is the smartphone in your hands. Please subscribe in order to stay tuned. According to the author, there are all kinds of broke. Sometimes you can have money, but you might be disadvantaged in some other way. Maybe you are a minority looking to open up a business in a mostly white community. Or you are a woman looking to get things going in a male-dominated industry. Or you are dyslexic like the author. Damon John points out that more than 35% of U.S. entrepreneurs have dyslexic traits. A disability of any kind forces you to compensate. It is a kind of asset because it forces you to assess a situation from all sides, to take your time until a solution becomes clear. It forces you to take a different path to the same goal. Damon John believes that there's tremendous power in being broke. The more you need to succeed, the more likely it is that you will succeed. The more you have invested, emotionally and personally, the more you will get back in return. The power of broke is about working harder, faster, smarter, and more efficiently. You don't have to be a tech visionary or to have millions of dollars. You just have to have the passion, ingenuity, hustle, and drive. An entrepreneurial heart. Money is no longer the catalyst. You and your ideas are the catalyst. Damon John shares stories to help you discover the power, possibility, and profit potential you have in being broke. Just like him, a dyslexic kid from Queens who was raised by a hard-working single mother. He confesses how he respects his mother because of her ability to think big. He shares that they live small, but there was no ceiling on their dreaming. You have to struggle, but then you have to do a little something more besides. When you are always reaching for that little something more besides, it starts to define you. Damon John had no choice but to be smart and creative, to think from a place of desperation. It was that sense of desperation that would become his fuel, that feeling that he has no option but to succeed. He was broke, but rich in possibility, hopes, dreams, determination. And that is the whole point of the book. That's what drove all these fine success stories, from a place of desperation to a place of inspiration. The author emphasizes that the power of broke only works in your favor if you recognize it, tap into it, put it to work. If you look broke in the face, define it, and make it a part of who you are and how you go about your business, then you've got something. Damon John doesn't suggest that the only way to start a business is from a place of desperation. He simply reveals that being broke can actually be an advantage in business rather than an obstacle. It forces you to be aggressive, creative, resourceful. It forces you to dig deep, to invest in yourself and trust in yourself, and to kick yourself in the butt enough times that the full force of your personality has a chance to shine through. Furthermore, if you grow up on the side of have not, you are used to hearing the word no. When you finally hear the word yes, you tear off after it, whatever it is you are chasing. It lights you up, fills you with possibilities. When you grow up privileged, you never hear no, so as soon as those resources are gone, you are in a tough spot. It's tough to recover, tough to look for another way to get to yes. In Damon John's opinion, one of the main reasons businesses go bust is overfunding. The more money you have at the startup stage, the more trouble you can have later. He thinks that all mistakes you make investing a lot of money, you can make with less money and you won't be in a deep hole. To avoid some of the setbacks, he suggests that every entrepreneur should have a mentor. A shark at heart, Damon John shares his shark point basics. Set a goal. A tangible, accessible goal. Aim shouldn't be too high or too low. You should think what is in reach, then reach a little more. Your goals don't have to be life-changing to get where you want to go, just life-sustaining. His advice is to write your goal down, so you say what you want, the date you want it by, how you are going to get there. The author claims that he himself has always had a healthy goal, a family goal, a business goal, a relationship goal, and a philanthropy goal. Do your homework. You should know your stuff, the history of your idea, your market, your competition. Homework these days means analytics, looking at others who have succeeded in the same field and also looking at businesses that have failed to learn from their missteps. You can find new selling opportunities, new methods of delivery, and new sources of revenue. The author believes that there are no new ideas, only new ways to execute those ideas. The more things change, the more they stay the same. So the game comes in how to figure out all these new variations on these old ideas and to find a way to get out in front of them. His advice is to use resources such as OPM, other people's manpower, other people's marketing, other people's mindset. Adore what you do. If you love it, you can find a way to make it work. Ask yourself, do you love what you do? Would you do it for free? If not, then maybe you should think about doing something else. You are the brand. It starts with how you carry yourself, what you put out into the world, the way you interact with your audience, your customers, the marketplace. The author insists on people being able to define themselves in 2 to 5 words. Keep swimming. You have to be relentless, nimble, moving ever forward. To succeed in social media space, you must be ever present, everywhere, all the time. When you hit your first target, go ahead and pick out another one, and another one after that. If you liked this video and you are a Shark Tank fan, you might want to check out our summary of Kevin O'Leary's Cold Hard Truth on Business, Money, and Life. Thank you for watching.